Hello, everybody. Welcome to Reggie Watts and Justin Roiland live in All Space VR. How's everybody doing today? Can I get some emojis?
Extremely tired.
Awesome. It is so great to see all you beautiful avatar faces. Oh, my gosh. It's Justin Roiland. Hi, Justin.
Hey, y'all. Can you hear me?
Hi. We can hear you great. You're fabulous.
Oh, man. You guys, look, this is my C-3PO impression. Oh, R2-D2. Oh, R2-D2, we have to hurry. We have to hurry, R2-D2. Does it kind of look like it? Does it look like it at all? A little bit?
Oh, my God.
Oh, R2-D2. Oh, R2-D2. Oh. That's all I got. That's all I got, ladies and gentlemen. That's it.
And thank you very much. Thank you so much, Justin Roiland. Thank you so much
worked
for coming.
All week on that
Evening
bit.
Zion. I'm just
I worked
kidding.
All week on that bit.
That's it, guys. Go home.
It was fabulous. I was
sorry,
actually
continue. I'm sorry,
them.
Lisa. Yes, please.
Oh, it's okay. Justin and Reggie are by far my two favorite people in VR, and they're now coming together, so you picked a great first event to be at.
There we go. All right, that's too. You're being too kind. You're being too kind now. That's not good. That's too kind. You're overselling it.
Okay, it's gonna suck. You guys shouldn't have come.
Get ready for the worst thing you've ever experienced.
Woo! Give it up with some emojis. Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, man. Look at all these wonderful people. How are you guys doing tonight? I'm excited to be here to introduce a man, a legend, one of the most creative minds alive today, in my opinion. His name is Reggie Watts. I don't know if you guys could tell that's where I was going with this. I'm not sure where he might be by the, have you guys checked the space out? Have you seen, I mean, Reggie could be anywhere. He could be hidden in the weird, you know, cemetery place where you bury people that have died. He could be by the tree that crashed into the car. I mean, the car that crashed into the tree that crashed into the car. You know what I'm talking about? He could be in all of those places. We don't know. We don't know where he could be. Maybe we should go for a quick little journey. Let's go see where he is. Lisa, what do you think?
You should do that. I think you should do that. That's great. I'm coming
Let's
right with you.
Let's go look for him. We're going to find him, guys. This is a team effort. Reggie! I'm going to check the haunted graveyard. Reggie! Reggie, are you okay in this scary? It's very scary here.
Where's Pathos?
Reggie! Oh, man. Reggie, where are you? Reggie! Reggie. Oh man, I feel like this is his car. This is the car that he said he was. Wait, let me check the license plate and make sure this is actually Reggie's. Oh my God, this is for sure his car. Guys, this is Reggie's car, you guys. This is Reggie's car. Oh no! Oh no! This is Reggie's car. Hey, hold on. Let me see it. Let me see if I can get to him in the window. Reggie, are you in there? Reggie, please. I can't see him inside. I think he might have stumbled out in the wreckage, maybe. Oh my goodness, I'm very worried. Are you guys all as worried as me? Oh my God, there he is!
Reggie! Guys, let's give it up for Reggie Watts and Justin Roiland.
Reggie, we were very worried for you. We were very worried for you.
Never be worried.
Get a front row in.
Come here.
There we go. There we go. Oh. I want to give him a hug, too.
I did it.
What? What's going on?
Why don't we take it on back to the stage, Reggie? Yeah.
Let's go. Let's go back there. Where's the stage? You know where it is? I'll follow you.
Okay. Follow me!
I'm just gonna drift up there because I'm really into the drift.
Yeah, we were all very worried. We went looking for you and then we found you right by your crashed car. Thank God you're okay.
I know, it's the ghost of me. Oh man, I love this hill. That's great. I love this thing. It is a tough hill.
The Beatles.
Open your arms to get up that hill, too.
Reggie, I think the Beatles created that hill. The Beatles.
I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm just teleporting now.
Where? Ah, I see.
Oh, I see. You're talking about the slide.
Yeah, yeah. See where you're doing this. I call it the penny whistle. I don't actually. There's no need to call it the penny whistle. Hey, how you doing, man?
How are you? Nice to see you in this amazing, haunted, spooktacular place that we've got.
Yeah, man.
How are all of you guys doing?
All right.
Good, man.
You guys are really good at that. Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Oh shit! Whoa, that was great. Well, yeah.
Hey, so thanks a lot for coming out, guys. We're gonna get into all the major topics that we're really excited about, like your weird arm.
He's like, check my out arm my doing? Weird arm, bro. Check
strong
it out.
The sailor.
I'm Weird Arm. I go.
He's Weird Arm, and I don't know what I am. I'm Guy. I'm just Guy. That's a.
I'm
okay.
I'm Regular Arm.
Hey, Regular Arms. So thanks a lot for joining us. I could tell some of you are seated. That's really cute. And this is one of the best barns I've ever been in.
Yeah.
I wonder if I can lean out. Let's see.
Let's see what we're dealing with here.
Oh, that's cool. You can see the beam behind this door. See that?
Whoa, holy
crap. Good, right?
You guys don't even want to know. You don't even want to know what's out there, man. That's the wildest thing ever. I will say, though, this is one of the best barns, as Reggie said, that I've ever seen and been inside. And I've been in a lot of barns. I mean, I don't know about you, Reggie, but yeah, I've been in a lot of barns. Like, you know, I majored in barns, just in general, just the act of barns, the construction and placement of them. And I got to say, this is in at least, this is a 703 level barn.
703.
That's barn talk.
But I mean, also you got to realize that, like, that over here, I mean, you don't get this kind of an angle. You know, you see the slope on this roof, which is really good for snowfall. You know, you're not going to get a lot of buildup. And
disperses the weight.
Exactly. So that's a huge deal. Also, I don't know if you guys are familiar. I don't know if you can. I don't think we can get up here. I've been trying to get up here for a long time, but. Okay.
Oh,
hey Bales, hey Bales, don't dream it's over. hold on, I'm trying. How do you get
this
up
is,
here?
Oh, this is
you
where, yeah. This
where'd
is where.
You, where are you?
This is
pumpkin. I love that. That's the answer. Pumpkin. Just pumpkin.
Pumpkin.
Oh, aim for the pumpkin. Oh yeah. Oh, okay. Cool. All right. Well,
yeah, you know,
this is one of the this is so spooky. There we go. Just want to take a quick look at here. Yeah.
Reggie, this is actually interesting, the part of the barn that we're in now, because I don't know if you guys know this, but this is usually the area of the barn where the barn owls will build their little nests and lay barn owl eggs. Yeah.
That's a true thing. That's so cool. Look at these two guys, just nicely framed in these windows up here. That's where owls usually hang out, and that's they're kind of representing. Yep.
That's where they fly.
Owl possibilities. That's where they fly. They are making eggs right now. If there are any ladies over there, they're probably making eggs right now.
Yeah, those windows are.
They're nice. I don't know how people get up there, but.
Hey, listen. If I was an owl, I wouldn't be complaining.
I know, I wouldn't be complaining. This is a nice barn, man, I have to say. I mean, I think we could just talk about how nice this barn is the whole time. I mean, it's incredible. Also, the light work and the shading, the polygons. I mean, come on. Look at this.
Come on, get out of here with these polygons. Get out of here with these polygons. Are you kidding me?
I can't.
This is crazy. I'm trying to not kid you. I'm like, are you serious? I'm looking at these polygons and I'm like, are you joking with me with these polygons? These are incredible. This is some polygon work. I mean, last time I saw a polygon this good, I can't even tell you. I was a little wee lad. I was this high. I was high. I was the size of this pumpkin.
I was about this
high when I saw the first polygon that was as even close to as good as this.
Like around there, yeah.
Yeah, it was about this big.
About that. Maybe like.
Somewhere in that neighborhood.
Yeah, right there. Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's rough. It's rough. that's great. That's great. That's so awesome. Yeah, I mean, I was probably like, let's see. Let's talk to Jesse over here. I guess I was probably like, maybe like that. Like that.
Okay.
Or no, sorry.
Yeah.
Like that. That's where I was at when I first discovered polygons, because you're a lot younger than I am.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, yeah.
So
you're about
like that.
You're about right there.
There, right there.
Right there. Okay. Yeah, I can see that. That's good. That's a good age to get a good polygon look. Yeah.
Yeah, totally.
So hey, what
you
want to
talk about? Your you want to talk about your? You were talk. You had a mushroom trip.
Yeah.
You want to talk about your mushroom trip?
Yeah. We could talk about that. We might as well.
What else?
I was gonna ask before we get into the mushroom trip thing, because that is an interesting tale. It happened just this last Saturday, so we'll tease that.
Yeah.
I also have a question for the room, for everyone. What do you all think about the Nintendo Switch? Excited?
Oh,
look.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not me. Heard
a fart noise.
True. Skyrim. Yeah. Oh man, that's true.
All right. Well, listen.
Okay.
I just want to know what you thought.
Sounds,
I don't know. Am I going to buy stock or not? I don't know. Probably not. Maybe.
You know, I like the idea of the Switch.
For those of you who are not in the same room as Reggie and Royland, they're saying, "Are you going to buy stock? Are you going to buy stock in Nintendo?" That's okay. That's what I'm here for. I'm here to ruin your show. Essentially, that's my job.
No.
I'm sure you'll love
me
by the end of the show.
Include everybody. You're the includer.
Okay, so here's how you buy. If you want to buy Nintendo stock right now for the Nintendo Switch, look down and there should be a little control button on the bottom. You should see it. It's just a little alt-space control button.
Everybody.
All you have to do
see.
Is delete Control Alt Delete your System 32 folder, and you'll buy stock in Nintendo. That's how it works.
Yeah, and it's so easy. We made it as easy as possible. Right. Although, Exactly. Thank you. Jesus, someone who can finally speak common person. So, if you really want to buy into Nintendo, now is the time. So, switch it out.
Switch it up.
I mean,
baby.
You've got Squanchtendo. Are you gonna create any peripherals, any devices for Squanchtendo?
I hope so. One of these days, I want a peripheral where it's like a big giant egg shell. Like from Mork's son, what was his name? Jonathan Winters, television.
Oh, Jonathan Winters.
Jonathan Winters. Yeah, so just a giant eggshell, and then you get inside of it like Jonathan Winters did, and then that's the peripheral that I want to make, but nobody's
so
interested.
That's so cool. People, you know what would be really cool is if it – what if it always stayed to your side, and that way it'd be a real peripheral?
Yeah, it's just like tied to your like a rope just connecting you
to the
everywhere
side of
you
your
go.
Head. Yeah, yeah, no matter where you look, it's like right here. That's real.
These are the kinds of things we want to bring to the masses. It's very
absolutely
important.
Nice high five over there.
So let's go back to the
designated area. Let's go back to here. Let's go back to one.
All right. Back to one, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's take that again.
Take it again from one.
Watch this Tokyo Drift.
So, how are you doing that? Oh, I think it's because
I'm Tokyo Drifting. You only have one controller, brah.
Yeah,
you gotta have the second controller.
I need it. I need my other controller.
Don't you have a support team? Just so you guys know, there's like a support team of 18 people in each of our houses.
It's true. Will the second controller?
Watch this. Watch this controller appear out of nowhere and land in his hand. Watch this. Look at that.
Watch. Get ready.
Almost.
Watch.
She's trying to give you hers. Look at that.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's not. Mine looks like Pikachu. You can't see it, but. Is there another?
Look at that. Look, your controller's there. Where's your controller? Where's your support team?
They're readying my other
controller
right now.
That's it. That really is.
Oh my god, that is it.
That really is it.
Oh,
I hope it hovers above your hand. Yeah, there you go. Now try drift.
Whoa!
Oh yeah, Tokyo Drift. There we go.
Wow, that's weird. All right, now we're two controlling it.
All right.
So do you want to hear? Do you want to? Okay. Should we talk about the weird shroom experience
mushroom
this weekend?
Yeah, let's talk about. Guys, you guys want to hear of a shroom experience? Even the people we can't see.
Yeah.
Guys, give some emojis if you want to show them to answer.
Yeah, oh, wow. Emoji.
It looks like a bunch of thumbs down. No,
boo.
Like, well,
you like they don't. Mushroom experience.
They don't. Okay, so let's talk about cafeterias.
I love cafeterias. They're so clean and nice. Hopefully this is an anticlimactic. Reggie, please, you can ask me questions as I continue through the tale. But so I had a little bit to drink, and I ate a little bit of weed chocolate. And I thought it would be a good idea. I was like, "Hey, I think this would be a good idea for me to eat this shroom chocolate I have, which I had at the time I had it. Now I no longer have it because I ate it, and on Saturday, and I ate it, and I was like, "Hey, this is gonna be great. I'm just gonna experience this, and you know, it'll be fun." And then I realized it was 4 a.m. And I was like, oh, that's not good. I didn't know it was that late. And I go and I lay in bed, and Abby, where's Abby at? She's in real world with me, next to me somewhere. Abby.
In world.
Where, okay. Abby? In world. Abby's in world somewhere, in real world. And I'm laying in bed, and I'm panicking because I'm seeing things, you know, how mushrooms tend to make you see things. And I'm thinking, I'm very melty, and I'm just like kind of like melting into the bed. And I was like, oh my God, I was so tired. And I was like, oh my goodness, I feel like if I fall asleep, I could maybe die in my sleep, but I'm so tired. What if I fall asleep and I suffocate to death? So I'm in bed at the peak of this shroom, this horrible mistake that I took these shrooms, and I'm laying in bed, and then I'm just like melting into the bed, and then I wake Abby up, who also has had, you know, plenty to drink and smoke herself of weed, and I'm like, hey, listen to me. I'm shaking her. Here, you be her. I'm like, hey, come here. Listen to me. Hey, hey,
what?
You gotta
listen.
Honey, you gotta keep an eye on me. Keep an eye on me because I'm drifting off to sleep, and I'm worried that if I cross into sleep, I may never come back. This could be it. I may never come back to this, to the mortal world. So just keep an eye on me, will you? Like, if you hear me choking not breathing clearly.
Okay.
And then I kind of rolled back and on my back, which is not a good, you know, you should really lay on your side if you're worried about suffocating in your sleep. So that's a tip for all the kids out there. Lay on your side if you're worried. If you're drifting off into sleep, you're worried you might suffocate to death. And then I fell asleep and I woke up the next day. I was fine. So can I get a round of applause for that little tale? Huh? Whoa, maybe. Whoa, baby. Yeah. Let's get a round of applause for that tale. That's an educationary tale. Educationary. That it's a cautionary tale. It's like a tale that says, hey, learn from me. Don't do as I do. Don't, you know. Right?
Don't.
Yeah, I woke up. Yeah, I managed to wake up. I don't remember. I have no recollection of any of what my dreams were. It was kind of just a big, just all of a sudden I was awake the next day. That's how it happened.
Did you die?
I know.
it's a big deal.
I survived falling asleep. That's right.
Man, you know, that reminds me of the time I did mushrooms once, or I took a mushroom chocolate, and there was no mushrooms in it, and I was like, ah, fuck. that sucked. Yeah.
I'll be the person you woke up in the middle of the night.
Okay.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Hey. Wake up, honey.
Yeah.
Sugar
yeah,
pants,
what's
crunchy
up?
Puffs.
What's up, sweet?
I took mushrooms. I took mushrooms before I took a nap, and I don't feel mushrooms at all. I'm really bummed.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, let's. Well, just I'm gonna keep an eye. I'm gonna sit up. I'm gonna sit around the clock. I'm gonna watch you. I'm gonna keep an eye on you. Absolutely.
Just make sure that I do get high.
You're gonna be okay. You're gonna be okay.
Oh my God! Wake up, sweetie! Wake up, sweetie! Wake up, sweetie! Wake
up! Am I high yet? Am I high yet?
Are you high? Do you feel
the
mushrooms?
I'm asking you. I don't feel any. I don't see any.
I think you're very high right now on the mushrooms.
What? Oh shit.
No, you're not. No, you're fine. You were just snoring.
I'm not.
You were just snoring. Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
That was Belgium chocolate. God. That was just regular Belgium chocolate from Belgium.
It was really good. Did you know that Belgium refused to sign on to the Canadian trade deal agreement?
I didn't know that.
Okay,
that upsets me.
There you go.
How dare they?
Yeah. I know.
How dare they do this thing?
I know. No, I did take mushrooms once, and I had a good time. But I remember I was in a forest. I was in a forest, and or you know what?
Virtual insanity is what we're living in. Well, you know, you were in a forest.
I was in a forest, and I was in my friend's lap. Like, she was cross-legged, and I was, like, had my head in her lap. and I was hearing her breathing, and we were under this huge tree in the Arboretum in Seattle, and I could hear her breathing, and I went on this journey like into the sacred female. It was like I went into this like crazy kaleidoscopic, like super ultra universal feminine vibe. It was really, really cool. And then I came out of it and I was like crying and stuff. And she was like, what's going on? I was like, I don't know. She's like, I think I know. And I was like, yeah, that's cool. That was, yeah. And then I went into a bathroom that happened to be open in the park. And I sat on a toilet and I put my head in my hands. And I was just like sitting on the toilet. I wasn't doing anything other than that. And then I just kind of went on this journey. Yeah, sorry. Sorry, just normsies. Yeah, toilet seat. It's just a seat at that point. I was just sitting on a toilet. But and not even the right way. But anyways, I basically met myself non-self. It was really cool. And I was like, ah, there you are. It's been a long time. That was kind of it.
Whoa, jeez. That's insane. That is insane. Can we get a round of applause for that? Because, like, I haven't had that happen. I haven't met my non-self. Although I did eat weed chocolate earlier, and I was having a panic attack about being in VR in front of people, so there's that.
I took a weed pill just before going on. I took a weed pill, guys. I took a pill. How many guys? How many of you guys that we can see? We know that there are other beings in the other universes that we can't see, but how many of you guys took some weeds? Okay. No one. That looks like it's about 60-70%. It's illegal. Turns out yeah. VR people, you know, they know how to do it right.
By the way, you know, I take it for medicinal reasons. You know, like,
so
you know, I have ADD. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? There we go. I have, everybody.
I have ad. Why doesn't anyone call it ad?
They should. I have should ad.
Guys, wait. I have ad. Oh, yeah. I have ADD and
why
it sucks
do
the
I ad. Have ad?
Hi, do you suffer from ad? before I forget, let's talk about your VR game.
Oh yeah, accounting.
Accounting. You guys, check
have you
this
guys
out.
All tried?
It's so dumb.
Very good. Accounting. Accounting is crows and Squanchtendo. I don't know if you guys have ever played the Stanley Parable or Dr. Langoskov. Anybody? Yeah, I see a lot of hands and hearts. So I worked with William Pugh on that and his comrade Dom, and those guys are like heroes to me. Like, they're just geniuses, and we it was just like this crazy game jam. We got together and made this insane experience. Did you try it, Reggie? Did you get a chance, or was it kind of
I didn't get back home soon enough.
Reggie played the first half of the game, pretty much. I would say, yeah. Probably every and back in during PAX West or Bumbershoot.
Yep.
Reggie and I hung out in real life in
real world,
you know, real space,
real space,
meat space, and space. And we run amok at the Valve offices, and I put him in an early build of accounting and. I remember your big note was like, can you make the xylophone with the skeleton bones a little more responsive? And I was like, I hope so. I hope we can. Awesome. I was like, I hope we could do that. Yeah.
Did you?
But yeah. I think it's still got quite
priority.
Like just a little bit of a lag. Yeah, it's like a little, but it's that's, you know, you look at the key pillars. What are the key pillars of the game? Is it a music xylophone game? No.
I think it is.
The point of the game is get to that part and fucking write music. Start writing music. That is where you are going to begin your musical career.
Exactly. Musical. Yeah, I like musicianal.
Yeah. Musicianal is a good word. Can we call Webster? Good. And I'm not talking about the show, the kid on the show. I'm talking about the dictionary.
The secret
people.
Passageways. Yeah,
right, yeah, he had the secret Webster. He had the crazy book or the what's it called?
Clock?
The grandfather clock.
Yeah, the grandfather
club. Dude, the dumb waiter. I mean, I grew up and I'm like, where's my secret passageways, Dad? It was like, you know, and he was like, get out of my face, you little rapscallion. My dad, Reggie, my dad lied to me when I was very young because I was begging him for this this little tiny battery-powered Pac-Man game. It was like, you know, this has had to have been early or mid-80s. And I was begging him for it. And he said, it reminds me of the old Calvin and Hobbes strips. He basically said, yeah, no, up in the attic above your bedroom, there's a whole toy store up there. All those things are up there. Everything you and you know, and he took me to Toys R Us, and he walks me through Toys R Us, and he's showing me, he's like that's in your, that's upstairs, that's in the attic, all this stuff, everything you see, all is in the attic. And I believed him. And then I remember it got to the point where I was bawling, I was sobbing, I was like, please, please, I want to go in the attic, please, why can't we go in the attic, why can't we see all these toys? And I had this vision in my head of this incredible, like, just fully packed, like, toy store up there, despite, you know, you go outside and look at our house, it's like there's no room, you know, it's like I'm a child, I'm a baby, I'm a kid, I don't know. And I'm my mom finally had to come out and go, enough, there's no toy store up there. She had to rip the bandage of truth off, or the bandage of lies, I guess, off. It's not real. Do you want to see? Yeah, of course I did. I'm lucky I'm still alive. I probably could have died up there trying to find the toys.
There was rat traps up there.
Yeah. Here's another one he did. Do you guys remember the movie Invaders from Mars, the 1996 remake? This is a deep cut, so it's fine if you don't. You saw it? Okay. It's really, if you haven't seen it, it's no. Invaders from Mars. It's the 1986. Jesus Christ, 1986 movie. Please, everyone, make mental note. Watch it this Halloween season. It's worth it. It's great. It's campy, but it's an amazing, awesome, fun movie. So in the movie, it's a kid protagonist, and, you know, he's seeing that aliens are basically taking over, and, you know, it's a Body Snatchers type thing. And they all have these little tiny band-aids on the back, just right on the back of the neck, right there. You see where I'm rubbing you? Right there. Right on the back of the neck, they had those little tiny band-aids. And those band-aids would hide where they drilled in this thing into the person's neck. And my dad, I'm 6 years old. I was born in '80, so I'm 6 years old. My dad takes me to the theater to see this. And then I'm scared, I'm freaked out. And then what does he do? He gets my mom, he puts one of those exact same band-aids on the back of my mom's neck. And then he comes and gets me, and he's like, hey, Justin, oh my God, something's wrong with your mom. Something's wrong with your mom. Come here. And he wasn't all crippled like I look right now. My dad's not all crippled, and he's not all crippled and weird like this. He was normally able. Not that there's anything wrong with being crippled. That's like, I am, God bless you. I donate money. I'm the most, I have so much empathy for, like, the, you know, everything. So he's like, come here, Justin, come here. Something's wrong with your mom. You need to come see. And then she's in the bathroom, and he told my mother just act like weird and drool and zombie-ish. And I just had a full-on, like, I flipped out. They had to just go, no, we're just fucking with you. You're 6 years old. It's fine. No. Here, look, take it off. My mom's name is Becky. Becky, take it off. Look, she's fine. She's fine. I'm sobbing. And it's like, we're just kidding. And then here's what they said. What is it called? Condolence prize?
Oh, condolence. What is it called? Consolation.
Consolation, there you go. I knew it was a C word. So here's your consolation prize. I went to a daycare at the time. They said, here, why don't you wear one of these stick? Why don't you go to the daycare and wear one of these bandages on the back of your neck and freak out all the kids there? And I'm like, and I did it, and I got through half the day before I realized none of these fucking kids saw this movie. I'm sick. This is a rated R horror movie. I'm six. This is not a condolence, or I got it wrong again. Condolence.
Consolation.
Consolation. This is, under no circumstances, this is a consolation for what you've done to me, Mom and Dad. You're crazy. Monsters.
Man, it's no wonder you're so
those are the things that shaped my adult mind, I feel like. experiences.
That's kind of amazing. I mean, if you think about it, I mean, that's kind of like activating your imagination where it bleeds into reality in that way.
Yes.
Like, it's kind of, I mean, it kind of like, it does open up your mind in a way, because once you realize that they were fucking with you, that like, that informs you that you can do a version of that, you know, for yourself to your friends or whatever, you know? So I don't know. Did you
What am I, Marty Scorsese? Scorsese over here? You go. Get it? That's a deep one. What am I, Marty Scorsese? You go.
Hey, you go. What am I, Francis Ford winemaker?
Oh my God, that is scary to do, by the way. That's horrifying what you're doing. You're gonna hurt everybody.
It's like, hey guys,
Oh my God, that's horrifying. Okay.
Anyways, When did you first start drawing and shit and making weird voices and stuff?
My first word was "fuck you, America." No, I'm just kidding. That's by the way. There was no political agenda there. I don't know why I said that, but I don't know. I feel like I was drawing, like, my mom used to describe pains in her stomach, like a weird sharp pain. And when I came out, I had a number two pencil sharpened, and I had all these little drawings. God. And the doctor was like, "This is incredible. I've never." Yeah. And the doctor was just like, "I've never seen anything like this before." And they they were gonna call the X-Files people, you know.
Right.
But then, they were gonna call him in, and it was gonna be an episode of X-Files. And then the people at Fox were like, I guess the head writer of X-Files was like, "Nope,
yeah.
Nope, not gonna happen on my watch, because this isn't Law and Order SVU unit." You know what I mean?
Wait a minute. So you're saying since you were born, that you've been involved somehow, peripherally or happenstantially, in the television industry, like immediately?
What's the guy that, you guys refresh my memory, I know his name, I mean, but like the guy that created X-Files, what's that guy's name again? Anyone?
Hank,
come on.
Chris Carter.
Yeah. Carter. Chris Carter slapped the contract. So when my mother and father were filling out my birth certificate with trying to figure out what they were going to call me, they also had a contract for the rights of my story to be a potential X-Files episode once that show got into development many years later in the future. And Chris Carter ran in the room and knocked it on the ground, and then this is what he did to it. Imagine it's right here. You guys see that? Imagine it's right – this is the contract right here. That's what he did.
Got a point right there.
He said, "No, I don't think so. This isn't what X-Files is about. This isn't about X-Files. This isn't what X-Files is. No.
Right here.
No. No.
And this is the contract.
Get out of here. No." Yep. And then he did this. That's and then crazy. He did this. I don't know if you guys can see my feet, but then he did this. Check he kind of went out, like guys. This. He did this. He kind of like he ripped it up. He stepped on one side, and then he used the other side to rip.
Oh.
And it was a lot of work. It was a lot of work. But he kept his hands free the whole time. His hands were free. They were just up here as he ripped the contract up like this.
That's so crazy, man.
Yeah.
That's crazy. So that's insane. So you lost an opportunity to be a part of the X-Files family.
Huge opportunity. I would have been a main character. The kid who drew a drawing in his mother's fetus, or in his mother's stomach, I mean.
His mother's fetus. Yeah, that's true. Because, you know, there's someone inside the fetus controlling it, so.
So somebody asked, what was the drawing? Well, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
It was a drawing of that weird bell thing that Hitler allegedly escaped at the end of World War II.
Oh, the time machine.
Yeah, the time machine. That's what it was a drawing of. Now, if that's not X-Files material, then I don't know, you know, what Chris Carter's thinking. But he ripped that thing up. Yeah. Oh, wait. Hold on. I see a hand in the air. How does that work again? There's the... Yeah, I see all these hands. I'm told if we click on a
hand... Are you supposed to click on them? Click on it. Like, do you click on the circle or the hand?
Let's just... I'm going to click on the
click
circle
on
the and hands. See what happens.
Click on the... Just
oh,
click
it's
on it.
There's a stranger is in the room. So is...
Oh, stranger.
Oh, your name tag.
Oh, hey.
Gamer's in
ahead,
here.
Go ahead, stranger.
Stranger, go ahead.
Hey, Justin, I was wondering, are you going to be on season 2 of Harmon Quest? Because I feel like you got a lot to offer there.
Oh, I would love to. I love board games. I haven't been asked, but like Harmon and I are buddies. I'll talk to him about it tomorrow. I'm gonna be with him tomorrow.
I'm gonna say, hey.
I want to do it too.
I'll tell him. But can we right here? We have to create a pact. Only if we're together. Only if he puts us in together. All right, here we go. Here we go. It's a virtual pact. Did a virtual pact.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
All right. How about Memer?
Memer.
Memer.
Memer's already gone. Oh, Memer's back.
No, Memer's here.
Memer.
Memer, you're on mute. Memer, you got to unmute yourself if you want your moment.
Memer, unmute Memer.
Don't ruin it.
Memer, Memer.
My name is Memer. Oh, there we go.
Thank you.
Oh, ooh, man.
What do you think?
Now, I've heard about these.
You're right. That is exactly what I expected.
I don't know if you've heard, Reggie, about these things called politics. They're called politics. Do they
Many
bite?
Ticks.
Do they bite? Like, do they cause
they
lung
do.
Disease like the other ones? I know there's are they like poly? Are they poly in the sense that they're like, you know, polyamorous and they sort of, they're the kind of ticks that sort of just, you know, like, you know, they have many lovers. They're, you can't hold me down. That's I'm a poly tick.
That's what it is. Poly ticks, and they can give you either Lyme's disease or Lemon's disease. It's like all the
strawberries disease.
Strawberries disease. Yes. A lot of sibilants. But I think it's safe to say that I'm definitely, you know, going to be here, so you know we can check it out.
I really want to make sure is that to make sure everyone knows that we know a lot of things about ticks, Lyme disease, polyticks. We know a lot about polyticks, but we also just want to say that they're not as bad, according to what I've read on the internet, as bed bugs. Bed bugs are apparently really worse than polyticks.
No, so. Those are gross. No. Yeah. And then I would suggest putting a mattress cover, a mattress protector. That'll make it harder for bed bugs infestations.
Right.
How about Viaria? Viaria.
Viaria. Okay.
Hi there.
Viaria.
Hi, guys. So,
hi.
Hello. Justin, I have a question for you.
Yes.
Are you ever going to finish your two Girls, One Cup series?
I mean, I feel like it's kind of finished, isn't it? I mean, were you imagining more episodes of like, where does this character go from here? I guess never say never, but... never say never, but yeah, maybe good old Cup will come back and have a bunch of crazy fun adventures.
Man,
that's great.
I think it's a great, you know, this reminds me of, I have a friend called the DGJ, and the DGJ has amazing questions. You should check it out. Go ahead.
Yes.
The DGJ. Yeah.
The GGJ.
Yeah. So Rick and Morty.
Oh, look, DGJ's got moving arms.
He's got moving arms and he's doing all kinds of moving arm positions. That's pretty great.
Custom avatar. Look at that custom avatar, guys.
He's also standing on a platform.
Yeah, you've got like a lift kit.
Yeah, he's got a lift kit. He's got a lift kit. Uh-huh. This is pretty fantastic.
Rick and Morty, will Reggie Watts have a role in the upcoming season of Rick and Morty?
Here's what I will say. All I can say is that eventually, you know what I'm saying? Eventually.
Eventually, yo.
Yeah.
It's in my contract.
Like yeah, it's in his contract. Oh, C-3PO. I mean, I'm C-3PO. R2. R2-D2. R2, hurry. Hurry, R2. R2-D2. R2.
Beep, beep, beep.
R2, we have to get out of here. This is dangerous. R2, this is dangerous here. R2, come back. R2.
Beep 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 boop boop boop.
Oh,
hey guys,
R2.
Boop 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 boop. I'm R2. Hi.
Hey R2.
I'm R2.
Hi.
Hi R2.
Can I ask you some questions, R2?
Sure, beep.
What is your favorite thing about the Star Wars world you live in?
Oh, beep beep beep. Beep boop beep 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 boop beep beep. Beep.
This...
Oh, beep, 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 beep.
Now that's
beep,
an answer beep. You can take home to mom.
Boop,
give it up for R2-D2.
Boop, beep, beep, beep. See you guys. Bye. Oh, crap.
Give it up for R2. Come
hey, guys,
on.
What's up? Hey, guys, I was just outside the outhouse. Did anything cool happen?
Yeah, Reggie, R2-D2 what? Is here. R2-D2 showed up.
R2-D2?
Yeah, I know how much you love him. I'm sorry that you missed him. He's like...
That's what?
It's
you guys joshing me?
No, Reggie talks about R2-D2 all the time, and I'm
that's
so
true.
Sad that you weren't here to meet that's... him. He did say hi to you, though. He said, in his own way, he said, please tell Reggie I said hello, and that I'm getting my degree in, he's going to some kind of medical school thing he was talking about, so it's exciting for
that's
him.
That's cool, so he took my advice. We were pen pals, I just never met him. That's cool. Well, yeah. Oh well. Anyway, so let's keep talking about technology. So I think let's take some questions. let's get some alternate unit. Oh, how'd you do that? That was really good. Let's see. See that again. Do that. How'd you do that? Was it just one? Oh, what are you doing there?
I don't know what's happening.
Okay, let's see. Let's take a question. I'm going to take one from this hand. It's a random hand. Let's see.
It's a random
oh,
hand.
Looks like, oh,
ladies
classic.
And gentlemen.
This is my friend. Guest 861-7965.
Ah, of course.
Guest
861-7965. They know who
but
they are.
I don't
are.
Think they have a microphone, do they?
Is
hey,
this,
guest 861-7965.
Yes, yes,
you're
on
the line.
Guest.
Okay.
First time visitor?
Okay. Yes, yes. So in Rick and Morty season one commentary, the first two episodes, you guys would like bust out into rap like all the time, and it was like a lot looser feel. Like, did you guys stop because standards and practices, or like what made you guys
Wait,
stop?
Do you mean? Do you mean in respect to the season two commentary or?
Yeah, it was like a lot more structured. I don't know.
There's an easy answer for that. And when we recorded the season one commentary, we got drunk. When we did the season two commentary, we were a little more sober and like in the middle of working. That's the most boring but true answer, I think.
Okay.
Question from Reggie.
We have an incoming question from Valent. Valent, unmute your microphone and present a question.
Valent!
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Gotta say, I'm a huge fan. I don't have a question. All I want to see is whether or not you guys can seduce my wife real quick. Just say something sexy to her. That's all I ask.
Oh shit!
Whoa.
No, no.
We got a cuckolder over here, ladies and gentlemen. We got a real cuckold.
Oh, yeah. Real cuckold. He's got a hold of his cuck. All right, hey, let's talk in private real quick.
Okay.
What should we say?
Two patties, one burger, cheese, and keep them separated. It's the delicious BLT from McDonald's. Did that work? Did I get it right
tonight? Thank you, gentlemen.
I think you did.
Is that how it goes? It's like, you remember the McBLT? The McBLT song. That's what I thought.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Cool on the cool side, hot on the hot side. Hey, let's see. There's another question here, right over here. Let's see. What is it? Who is it? Let's see. Oh, God, this is a weird one. TRAVIS.
Travis.
Hey. What do you have to say?
Guys, you just got the AltSpace VR fanboy.
Hey, Travis.
I'm an AltSpace employee here at the office in Redwood City, California. Just want to say you guys hey. Justin, I got a really important question for you. So I believe you have Andy sitting next to you, right?
Andy? Yeah, where is he?
So I wanted to know if... Well, Andy should be there in your place, Sam? Right? Like helping you run the event. Or Sam. Andy or Sam.
Sam.
Yeah, so could you do me a huge favor?
Sam!
Do me a huge favor. Could you just draw any monster that you can come up with, and I'll get it tattooed on my body tomorrow?
Are you fucking serious?
Look at the Sam, and I'll get it tattooed on my body.
Will you tweet the image at me, and I can retweet it?
Promise. Just please don't make it with a penis, and I'll do anything else.
I'll keep it G-rated. It'll be G-rated.
Dude, I'm so excited.
I'll keep it PG-13. I'll keep it 80s PG-13.
Perfect.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about, brah.
The whole office laughing over here, guys. Thanks so much.
What do you guys...
No worries. Let's take...
Reggie, I was going to ask the whole group before we take the next question.
Yeah.
Have you guys all been watching a lot of scary movies because it's October time?
No? Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Not really.
Anybody? Count Dracula, great movie. Invaders from Mars, great one.
The 1986.
Mean Girls. Scanners. How about The Gate?
Oh, The Gate's great. Gate? I love The Gate.
I love The Gate.
Remember Gate 2 with the poo-poo?
I did.
Poo-poo money?
I didn't see
Gate 2. You never saw Gate 2? Oh, you gotta see Gate 2 with the poo-poo money. Oh, man, the Kyoto Brothers.
Okay. Alright. How about Mothman Prophecies? That's a good one.
Is it? I haven't seen that one.
Okay.
Oh, have you guys all seen The Mist?
Actually, it's
Frank Darabont? The Mist?
I love The Mist.
It's so good, isn't it? If you're a fan of The Walking Dead, you should watch it.
I saw it a long time ago. Oh, by the way, you said Walking Dead. You said Walking Dead. How many saw the first episode of season 7?
Oh, God, don't. They're going to spoil it. They're going to spoil it.
No, there's nothing to spoil. I'm just saying, like, I sincerely mean this. Do not watch it. It's so depressing. It's the most depressing episode of television I've ever seen.
Well, now I have to watch it.
Well, let's take a question from a ham-sized ham hand.
Oh.
Okay. I'm taking from a hammed. Okay. Oh, looks like we got another complicated one. We got pale.
P-A-U-L.
Pyowl. Oh, thanks. Hey. Oh, the Illuminati. The opinion of the Illuminati. Well, you know, I'd like to think it's a good board game, but I would say, you know, Illuminati, you know, they're all right. I mean, they've never really done me wrong.
Hey, listen, we're on the list to get in, so we can't talk smack about them right now. We're about to get in.
That's actually true.
We're about to get in.
But we want to make our way into that system and change that system from within.
Yeah.
Yep. I mean, like work my way in, and
that's
then
how
just
kind
of work it in. Just kind of work it out.
You got it. You got to start from within.
Yeah. Well, so
It's but to answer your question,
I think it's, you know, it's good. It's good, PL. Thank you, PL. Thank you so much.
Hey guys, can we get can we deliver a question that came from Twitter? We got a question from Twitter. Okay, Twitter quest. Perfect in time for Halloween. What is the best way to achieve my dream or being the first person to die in VR?
Oh, that's easy. Don't do that. I legally clarified, you shouldn't do this because I don't want to get sued. But the best way to die in VR, I would imagine, is to like just swallow a ton of some kind of really deadly pill and then just go into altered state or Vanishing Realms or something, and then just kind of go to the Vanishing Realms, get to the forest, and then just lay on your back and look at the beautiful VR moon and drift off into the peaceful everlasting sleep. Now listen, I'm not telling you to do that.
Yeah.
I'm just saying if one were to that, I feel, or you could also get a tie a hose to your car exhaust, run it, snake it into your VR room. And then, like, you know, go into, and same thing, go into Vanishing Realms. Plastic up your windows. Yeah. Go into Vanishing Realms again. Yep. Go to the forest, lay on your back, and just drift off into a peaceful, blissful, ever after. What do you think?
Oh, you know what? Here's a fun way. If you get one of those Omen backpack computers for VR, and like, so you got backpacks, so you're completely untethered, then go up in a plane. And just jump out without a parachute. just do a little.
Oh my god! If you could time it, you know. Oh my god! Okay, wait. Can I pitch on that? What if you say all the same parameters, please, but you boot up Windlands? Anyone play Windlands? And then you go onto a really tall building. You go into a really tall building, and you kind of like you take the head. You take your headset. You kind of make sure. Okay, I'm right at the edge, and then you squeeze the triggers and jump up. Off the building, and then time it so that when you actually hit the ground in VR, you will really hit the ground in real life. That's great. That's a good. That's tops right there.
That's a good one.
But it does require. You have to have that computer. You have to have that computer with you to do it.
Gotta have that backpack computer, guys. And also the most recent update of Windows 10. So. So that's a good one. Complicated, but it's a good one. You get it running. It would suck if you glitched on the way down. You'd be like, no. Guys, let's take. Is there any more Twitter questions?
Yeah, any more Twitter?
There's tons of Twitter questions. I can ask next one.
You want to find? You want us to take a regular question? You find a good one. Oh, okay, Gary.
Where is VR animation? Give me a posable puppet theater with a microphone input and a timeline.
Oh, I think that's coming. There's a program
Mind Show. Just kidding.
Oh, Mind Show. There you go. Yep, you got it.
Yeah,
no, Mind I think Show. That's what it's called.
Okay.
I swear to God.
Yeah,
Mind Show. Yeah, it's coming. It's coming. Mind Show. It's coming.
Mind Show's cool. It's basically
it's
like what
Hang
we're
on.
Doing on stage. It's good. It's good, but you can record
yeah,
it.
You can like
play
create.
You create your own show.
There's also another.
Basically.
There's another one called like. Anything or any place? Anyone know that one? Any place? That's another one that's really neat. Any land is another good one.
Oh,
any land.
Inland. It's actually Inland. Inland.
Inland. Inland. Yeah. Created by Evelyn. Evelyn created it.
Oh, you know what? I thought it was Evanescence, but it is Evelyn. Okay, cool. guys, do we have any questions about Papa Roach or Better Than Ezra?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's take, let's take this one.
Actually.
Which one's better? Let's take this one. This one is another one of those weird ones. It's
Papa Roach.
Jamez.
Yeah, I'm glad you picked me. I've had this Papa Roach question for about a year and a half, and I was hoping that either of you could help me answer it.
Good.
We are the Papa Roach people.
On the last Papa Roach tour, we were, you know, hanging out after the show.
We were hanging out after the show, you know, waiting for Steve to come out and, you know, go to the tour bus and... Usually they don't talk to us, but they talked to us, and he'd mentioned both of you actually. I had no idea that you guys followed them around on tour. You never said anything about that. What's going on there?
Well, yeah. I can tell you two reasons. Reason number one, Pippi Longstocking. That's the first reason, and Reggie knows the other.
Pippi Longstocking, definitely a huge fan of very strong red-headed pigtailed girls with secret treasure under their houses. The second reason...
Who are completely emancipated from any sort of parental,
oversight?
What is it? You know, jurisdiction? Oversight,
yeah, there you go. Yeah, oversight, jurisdiction. I'd say the other one is that We're huge, both of us, and this is why we kind of found each other. It's like Rick and Morty is like, you know, I was like, oh, I got to check that out. I still got to check it out. No, I've checked it out. But anyways, but the thing that we really love together is we love grindcore. Like, we're huge fans of grindcore. And and because of that, we just kind of came together and we found Papa Roach. And they're not totally grindcore, but they're like, they're kind of a new breed. So I don't know. I just really liked them.
It's a new era of grindcore. It's a new era of like papas and roaches and like if you really know
a lot of
what it's about. There's a lot of papas. But yeah. And it's true.
Rage. Yeah, it's the rage alternate. It was like, you know, because everybody was like Rage Against Machines. Forget it. I don't care.
Yeah, get out of my machine with that rage.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you with Papa Roach, the big thing they said is they're like, our next album title is called Pippi Longstockings. So that's why
Know
about that. Pippi Longstockings.
That's right. That's why. Fuck, I forgot. Shit. Do we have any better than Ezra
Pippi's
questions?
Longstocking.
Pippi's, it's Pippi's Longstocking because they were like, aren't we clever?
Pippi's with an apostrophe. Kind of cool. And then on the cover art, it's just a long stocking. It's just the most insane stocking. And then they're talking about merchandising a really crazy stocking for the fans to buy. It's just it's unusable. It's so long, and there's only one. So it's like, you can't even... I mean, I guess you could cut it in half, and then maybe you'd have it... You could actually cut it in a four.
Still be pretty long.
It's one stocking, but it's enough to cover a whole family of four. Their entire legs. It comes bundled in.
Okay.
Yeah. It's so stupid.
Let's take a question for better than Ezra. We've got a Seymour. Suddenly Seymour, you gotta unmute your mic. Yeah, why don't you come forward, Seymour?
There he is. Come forward, Seymour.
Okay. Hello.
Have either of these Ghostbusters?
They mean the newest one?
Have ever...
No. The newest one?
Older Busters?
Ones. Oh, yeah. Are you kidding? I love the Ghostbusters.
Is he talking about the old Ghostbusters?
The old Ghostbusters.
Hey, I ain't afraid of no ghost. Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
High five,
yeah. That's good.
I ain't afraid of no ghost.
Just how rude is.
That's
I ain't afraid of no ghost.
I'm not afraid of no ghost either. Oh, and the flowers are still standing. Huh? No? Okay.
Yep.
Okay, let's
Let's.
Wait, was he talking about the old animated
Ghostbusters
comic book Ghostbusters? The
no, old he's talking one, about the movies.
No, no, I'm just talking about
okay, movies.
Because okay. Right. Like, yes, so. The answer is yes. If that's
yeah, yes.
I love the way, Ghostbusters.
They're a good band of people, and I like them, and I like their converted. They were very scrappy, and they would convert hearses into productive vehicles. So it's kind of cool. It was a good movie. The new Ghostbusters I haven't seen because I didn't want to be disappointed because I heard a lot of disappointing things, but I think it's probably pretty good. Let's take another question, this time from the farthest hand I can see in the distance, and that would be
Tall. Yes.
Tall.
Reggie, Tall.
Tell us your question.
What are you doing here, Reggie? This is your mother.
Tall. Oh,
I told you to stop hanging out around with this weirdo.
She sounds so African.
Oh, my goodness.
That's squanchy.
She's
That's
right.
That's a reference.
She's right, Reggie. She's sorry, right.
Mom. I'm sorry. Do you have a question?
I'm disappointed, you, Reggie. You're grounded.
Oh, man. That is the weirdest Nigerian accent I've ever heard. Okay. What are you doing,
Tall? I'm
not
Nigerian, Reggie. Stop being racist.
I'm not. Hi. Hold on. Hey, do that again. I want to take a picture of you.
Get this squanchy fell off me, Wedgie.
Oh shit, you got lower. Somehow you got
He's squanching all over me.
I don't even know if I can. I think I'm disabled. I think I'm disabled. I can't take a picture.
He's okay. Squanching.
You know, it's funny. Reggie, it's funny, there are hundreds of people out there that are disabled every day in their normal just life. And like it's crazy to think like
sorry.
That just for a moment, you were disabled, and it's isn't that crazy? Where it's like, oh my
Actually,
god, I was
no,
disabled.
Right. Yeah, I don't think of it that way.
It's
because I'm like, what don't I have? You know, I'm thinking of it in that way. I'm like, what's not working? But in fact, like some people, it's never going to work. You know what I mean? They're going to have other things that are going to work.
And it really puts things into perspective when you are in that kind of a situation. You know. Anyways, that's a pro-disabled conversation.
Hey, I wanted to take a question. Who's this guy? Sorry to interrupt. I'm just seeing a local area network.
Local area network. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, you're right. You got it.
Oh, hello. Hi. Do you have a question?
Network.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's reverse springtime now, and I just wanted to know if you guys prefer chili or stew.
Oh, stew. Although chili, yeah, I wish you could. Hey, let me see if I'm disabled. I'm not disabled. I'm still. You're making chili right now? Okay, maybe chili then for me. Chili.
I want chili. I would take stew though for holidays, but I'd also eat chili. Listen, you put it in front of my face. I'll eat it. You know what I mean?
I've seen your face eat stuff.
High five on that one. Doesn't matter what it is. Pennies, magnets, you put it in front of my mouth. You can't be sure I won't swallow it.
That's a face of an eater. That's the face of an eater.
Look at this fish right here. Look at this eater face. Hello.
Look at that. Hey, let me get you something.
Yeah, give me something to eat. Let's go find
something.
Let's
go find something to eat.
Let's go find a snack. I know there's got to be...
Let's see.
Oh, yeah. There's got to be something in this graveyard here for sure, right?
Let's check it out.
I mean, you know... Oh, look who lies here. Batman.
Hey, Justin, yes. There's a person.
Pepsi! Oh, wait, where is
Pepsi.
It? Where's...
Where? Oh, where are you?
Oh, hello,
hi.
Pepsi.
Hi, young lady. Hey, this is young lady Pepsi.
Hello. Pepsi!
What the young lady...
Crystal Pepsi.
Yeah, motherfucker! Yeah, 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 yeah!
Yeah.
For those of you who can't see, Crystal are hugging Reggie.
Remember, not everybody can see them. And they're dancing while they're hugging. There's a big dance fest going on here.
Crystal Pepsi!
I like that you're kind of like the interpreter.
I am the interpreter.
For those of you who are visually impaired.
Can you see
it? Hey, all right!
I'm hanging out with Justin. So Justin, Pepsi,
if you're watching this, all hanging out. If you're watching this on a replay, just get in where Crystal and Pepsi are standing right now. If this is a replay,
give me some emojis if you can see both Pepsi and Crystal. Give me some emojis in the other rooms, please. Okay, so they're married now. I don't know.
I have my foot up. You can't sit.
Holy shit.
I wish we were in a speedboat. Woo! Yeah! America! All right. Cool. Hey, well, now that we're here, should we have the seance? What were you gonna say?
Yeah. Oh, I was gonna say, now that we're here, we should have our seance.
What did you say? Say it again.
I said, now that we're here, I think we better have our seance.
A seance, right. Okay, cool. All right, so let's, I guess we need, I'll start it off by, we need him facing north, south, and east, and west.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
So let's see. Sorry. I have eight technicians messing with my sensors right now.
Controllers in the middle. This is our offering.
Yeah, guys, put all these controllers here. It's going to be the largest controller stack in history. Yeah, but. It's so stupid.
Now.
And for those of you not in the same room, we just got a whole bunch of Vive controllers getting put in the middle.
Now, if we do this, for long enough, all the way up to the tree, please.
Oh, look at that! So beautiful. I wish we were on a ladder.
All the way to the tree.
Look at the spinal column. It's amazing. It's a brachiosaurus column. Okay, guys. So, okay, now we just need to hit the same tone. We have to hit the same tone. So we're going to, I'm going to start the tone and you guys just like start on the same tone. You guys ready? Okay. And I'm going to say a quick incantation. Yeah. Oh, great spirits of the virtual world, rise into the knowledge of tree-ism. Please hear our tone.
Translating for the other people not in the space, there's somebody Catherine in here who just got scared and ran away from Reggie and Roiland. We're talking to her. They're now on the search.
Okay, I'm leaning in. Oh, there's nothing.
Don't lean too far.
There's nothing on the other side.
Whoa, there's people over there.
What happened to
Catherine?
Whoa,
how'd you get over there?
Well, I don't know.
Wait, is that
she ran?
Is that? It's Catherine, right here. She screams over here.
Oh, she's over here, guys. Quick, go get over here. Tell us your story. What brings you to this world? What brings you to our world, Catherine?
What brings you to our mortal coil?
Catherine. Catherine, it's so...
Catherine. You could be Catherine if this is a replay.
Oh, she disappeared again.
Just stand.
Oh, no.
No, she's here.
Whoa. Where is she now?
You okay? No.
Oh, she's...
Catherine is putting them on a scavenger hunt.
What a ghost lady. Oh, wait a minute. Something's over here, guys.
Pepsi.
Mary.
Pepsi and Catherine.
Oh, Mary, they're coming for you.
Mary.
Oh, man.
Look at that. She's so still and perfect. And look at her tiny feet. They're so tiny. They're the tiniest feet in the world. two golf clubs. Two golf club feet. Hi, Mary. What are those, 10 irons?
Whose car is this?
Follow her. Follow Mary. There's something about her.
Whoa. Uh-oh, guys, be careful.
What's over here?
What's over there? Oh, what's over there, Reggie?
What is it? I can't quite get over... A group picture?
Oh, Sarah's stuck in the car. We gotta go get her.
Oh, shit. No! Sarah, I think I know how... Sarah, I know how to get you out. Sarah, cars are booing. Oh my god, I didn't notice that it was steaming. Oh, that's crazy.
Reggie, help!
Sarah, I think you're gonna... Oh no!
God, Reggie, help!
Justin,
help! I drove wrong!
God damn it.
I drove wrong.
Justin, can you see my hand?
Yeah.
Can you see my hand?
I drove wrong.
Grab, wrong. I'm trying to pull you out. But what about Sarah?
We did it.
Sarah, get it. Oh, Sarah! Yay! Hey, Sarah. Hey, Sarah, you're going to have to replace your radiator.
Smile.
Hey, Sarah. Sarah, over here. Y'all going to have to replace your radiator, okay? Y'all have to replace the radiator. Oh, what's she doing? Oh, thank you. I'll put this in my pocket.
Put it in your packet. All right.
Okay.
I'll get to work on it.
All right, well, yeah, get to work on it. I'm going to go around the other side. Okay, here. What do we got over here?
Well, it looks like your radiator's all wrong.
Yeah,
she got
looks,
three radiators.
Like oh, shit. Well,
she's got three.
Are they all
broken?
You
only need one radiator. All three of them are shot. What kind of mess have you gotten yourself? She got herself into a real doozy, this one. Well,
oh God.
We're going to have to call in Joey to fix it.
Hey, I'll give him a call right now. Hey, Joey? Hey, Joey, can y'all come down here with the AAA truck? Okay. Yeah, there's a boulder in front of the road, but you can move it if you got a crane. Okay, cool. Hey, guys, he gonna be here soon. Joey. Oh, that's true. Listen
Leah
to her.
Leah said that she has a car mechanic in front.
She does. Oh, yes? Can you have him come into this reality?
Oh.
Hey.
Oh.
Steep, isn't it?
Oh. It's very steep. It's slippery. Don't fall. It's slippery. Oops. Oopsies.
Whoa. Jesus Christ. Whoa. Hey. Whoa, you okay?
Whoa.
Okay.
Whoa.
Oh, shit.
I'm all right. I got a real... That was a real one.
That was a real doozy.
Oh, wants to go rock climbing. I'm going rock climbing. I don't care what you say.
Okay, good luck.
I'm going up.
It's a steep hill.
See y'all later up here. I'm going up to the teepee top.
Oh, that's good. Keep going. Hey, can anybody help him? Maybe give him a boost? Oh, shit. Okay, now we got... Oh, look, there's a big jive hand up there.
Oh,
who is that?
Oh,
it's a big ham.
It? I'm clicking it.
Oh no, I'm trying
I'm clicking it.
I'm trying to get that piece of ham. Oh, that piece of ham disappeared. Oh, wait a minute, there it is again.
Oh.
Okay, no, it's not selected. I can't. Yeah, I know.
Can't.
You guys just beamed in Bass Spoon. Bass Spoon's in the house now.
Bass Spoon. Is that the mechanic?
Bass Spoon!
Bass Spoon, you're on mute. You gotta unmute yourself.
Unmute yourself.
What up?
All right, Bass Spoon, what you got?
Nothing really.
Okay, see you later. Bye, Bass Spoon.
Bass Spoon. I know that name. Bass Spoon's a name I know.
Ghost in the house.
Oh, we got guest 190215. Who? Ghost?
Ghost is behind you. Be careful. You got a ghost.
Ghost Recon?
Holy shit! Oh, holy fuck! God damn it! Ghost! What's wrong with you? Okay. All right. Ghost. We come in peace. You got a question, Ghost? Or are you just going to sink into the ground? Nope. Okay. Well, see you later. Sheesh. How about Ghost? 190215. Anybody? Guest 190215. Going once. Going twice. Going three times. And. Yeah, I know, but they don't even got a mute symbol. So I don't even think they got a microphone. Maybe they do. I don't know.
Oh, they are muted. I think you're muted.
I didn't design Alt Space.
Guest 19.
Oh, there's Boba Fett. Oh, there.
Am I in the zone?
There's Boba Fett.
Hey guys.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey Boba.
What's the word on Gloop World? Is that happening still?
Yeah. Yes. I can't say anything officially, but it's moving along. It's moving along.
Yeah. Cool. Well, my brother's a stop motion animator, and he told me about the project. Very excited.
Oh.
Yeah, but why is he against motion? Why is he against motion?
Stop motion.
Get rid of it! Get rid of it! Yeah.
I'm sick of this motion.
Stop it! Okay.
You gotta stop the motion!
I'm trying to find Who are you looking for?
I might be able to help you, Reggie. I might be able to help you.
Where's Catherine? Is that her over there? Oh, there she is, guys. Go get Catherine.
There she is. Catherine!
Go get her. Go get that Catherine.
Get her. She's going.
Yeah,
she's going.
Go get her.
Get that.
Y'all go get her.
Get her. She's going.
Get that pork rind. Go get her.
She's going back to the stage area.
Why?
She's going back
to the
stage area.
Oh no, look! Buzzy, what'd you do? Oh, Buzzy.
Buzzy.
It was murder most foul.
Oh, Buzzy body. What a Buzzy body. Okay, well, fuck it. Well, you know what? Let's just leave him up there. It's Halloween. Yeah, for next year. Yeah, just leave him up there for next year.
Hit him with the hind. Let's hit him with the hind.
And look. Oh, hey, Tammy, be careful up there. Tammy, be careful. For those of you in alternate dimensions,
Tammy is waving and flailing up at top.
Yeah.
Reggie's trying to make sure Tammy's safe.
Yeah.
It's Tommy, sorry. Okay.
I thought it looked like
Thank
an
you,
A.
Ty.
I'm
We've
sorry.
Been corrected.
Jesus.
It's Tommy, even though it's T-A-M-I.
It makes a difference. Okay.
Tommy.
Right. Well, Hey, Tommy. Let's
head
go back to this
reality. Yeah. I love the ambience out there.
Did that even happen? Did that even happen?
It was a nice creepy ambience out there. That was pretty nice.
a nice little thing.
That was really nice,
now
guys.
Now we're in the safe barn where the with the barn owls and everything. So
this feels so much
we
nicer.
We want to thank everybody.
Yes, everyone.
Should thank everybody for even especially let's do the credits list. Our favorite people. There was
you go first.
Who could forget? Pepsi. There was Crystal Pepsi. Or I guess they were together. They were a duo. There was Tommy, and Alik.
Yeah, that's it. You got it. Yeah.
There was so many.
Sarah.
There was guest 1, 4, 6, 3, 2, 5.
Yes. Thanks for correcting us on that one.
Yeah.
Oh, Catherine.
And then last.
Yeah, there was Catherine. Catherine.
My favorite.
Hey, we want to thank Alternative Space for providing another space that's different from the usual one. I want to thank the support teams here at our house, all 18 of you that are in each of our houses. I want to thank barn designers, the people who created this creepy world for you guys to hang out in. That's a big deal. It's really cool. Big claps.
Yep.
Yeah, put them up.
Look at these claps. Look at this clap.
Whoa. Yep. Oh, wow. That's something.
That's a clap.
I'm just doing
that's
that.
That's when you know you care. That's when you know you really clap, care y'all. About it. When you clap like this, you can't clap.
Yep. I'm alligator man.
You gotta do the little clap. Clap.
Yep.
Clap.
Yep.
Clap. Clap.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, your hands are fancier than mine. I can't get them right. Hey, we want to thank Swenson's Farm for providing all this hay. Also want to thank Swenson's Farm for these huge pumpkins. It's hard to get these, and we got them just in time. So
when you
thank you,
need
Pumpkin Master.
Hey, call Swenson. That's their jingle they told us to do.
Swenson. Hawkins. Swenson. Everybody, on 1, 2, 3, we're going to say bye, Swenson. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Bye, Swenson.
Okay. Nice
obligation
work.
Fulfilled.
That's as good as it.
Oh, yeah. Do we?
Oh, yeah. You just.
Okay,
you
somebody
just
asked,
click on a
guys, somebody asked, do you have a promo code for the Nintendo stock? For those of you
yeah,
who
you just have to, you just have
Ameritrade.
To click on the pumpkin, one of Swenson's fine pumpkins here. Just click on it, and that will get you in to the official E-Trade commerce stock business, officially.
Yep.
So that's all it takes.
Yep.
And give yourself a round of applause if you did it, because that just means you bought a whole bunch of stock for free. Give a round of applause here.
Yeah.
Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson.
Bye, Swenson. I'm kicking chairs. I'm stuck in my chair. Hold on.
Oh my god.
Oh man, whoa.
Hold on. Whoa. Oh, hey, hold on. Okay, here we go. That's what I always want to do. Stiff as a feather. Stiff as a board.
Now here we go, ready?
Stiff as a board.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Oh, shit.
Go.
Sorry, man. Sorry. Hey, Justin, you're taking big steps. Hey, Justin, where are you? Justin. Hey, Justin. Justin.
Yeah.
Where are you? Hey, Justin. Where are you? Okay. Hey, guys. All right. Okay. I don't even know how I'm.
Oh no, you got her.
Oh, no. Okay. Uh-oh.
Whoa.
Whoa. Okay.
Whoa.
Hey, guys.
Whoa.
I don't know what's going on.
Whoa.
Oh, shit. Whoa. Okay.
Whoa.
Okay. All right.
Wow.
Oh!
Wow!
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 Okay.
Well, that about does it for our show today.
That's pretty good.
Hey, everybody, give it up for Reggie Watts and Justin Roiland.
Somebody get a picture of this. Back to...
Guys, we have an All Space VR tradition where we get selfies with the guests of honor, except people can't get a selfie on stage with you. You're going to have to move over to another part of the
All right, let's do it.
Oh. You'd be willing to do that with us?
I actually, kind of like this. Aside. Yeah, where would you guys like to go?
Outside.
Yeah.
Pumpkin to the
Scarecrow
Cemetery.
The graveyard.
Scarecrow!
Go, Scarecrow. Go to Scarecrow mode.
Guys,
oh, this hangy McHangerson.
Take advantage of this. Taking advantage of my leg being out like this.
Okay, guys, okay, you know the drill. Let's get some serious emojis happening. You're gonna have to give me 1 second because I've got to get another
good foot massage.
Yes, thank you.
Did you? Hey, did you get the camera?
Get the emojis, rocking.
Who's taking the picture? Is it Lisa?
Hey, check
Lisa.
Me out.
It's which?
Yeah, check
which
me
Lisa.
Out, yo.
Yeah,
Lisa,
check
are
me
you
out.
Doing that? Are
everything
you...
all set up? I know.
Lisa, do you have the DSLR? Are you using a DSLR? Are you using your phone?
I'm using some magic thing. Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
well, I'm just saying, like, you might as well, if you have a DSLR, use that.
Okay. I'll talk to the staff on that. I'll have my people talk to your people, and we'll make sure that happens. Okay, guys,
okay.
Look at me. Look at the camera. Be beautiful.
I don't see the DSLR.
Okay. It's a magic one. You won't be able to see it, but trust me, it's here.
Okay, I see.
Okay, you guys look amazing. Thanks so much. I know that Alt Spacers, we enjoyed
it.
Show them how
I
much
didn't
you
hear
enjoyed
a click.
Us. Trust me, we got pictures of you.
Oh my god.
Hold on, it's gonna get better, guys. It's about to get a whole lot better. All right, hold on. Okay, uh-huh. Okay, hold on.
Oh, this
is gonna be great. All right, this is gonna be some good shit, yo. Yeah.
What?
Hey, y'all.
Hey, I've got a sensor. It's coming off. Hold on. I'm putting this back. I don't know where it's going.
I'm Irish.
That's racist.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. I wonder what'll happen. Okay, what if? Hold on. Yeah, just like let it fall to the floor.
This is gonna be so terrible.
Oh wait, are you doing what I'm thinking you're doing?
Yeah, I think so. Hold on.
Hold on,
okay.
Will you guys start dismantling my...
Yeah, exactly. This is our dismount.
Yeah, this is the dismount. I'm gonna hold very still.
How do I look? I look cool? Yeah.
Man, this feels so good.
This feels like me more. Yeah, I mean, I do love this leg right here. That's just cool. You don't get that anywhere except for long space.
Look at me! Look at me! Oh, sorry. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez.
Yeah, totally. This is Halloween shit right here.
That's awesome.
Oh, my God.
Oh, God.
Someone take a picture.
Oh, God.
Justin, you okay?
Oh,
Justin.
No.
Oh, no. What's going on? Oh,
no.
Jesus.
No.
Oh, God. What's happening with your hand?
Oh, no.
Oh, God. This is terrible.
Oh.
Guys, you're not meant to see this. You really... Oh, no. Oh, my God. Justin! No! Justin!
No!
No!
I think I'm frozen.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah.
Woo! Why did you let the dog into the bed?
USA! USA! Guys, this is the best that Silicon Valley has to offer, guys. Get a load of it. This is called floating pretzel.
Give it a few more years, and then you'll really see floating pretzel.
Hidden boyfriend. Okay. All right. Okay, y'all.
Thank you, guys.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
You guys.
We're gonna leave
you guys
now.
The best.
Thank you so much.
All right, guys. Yeah. Give it up.
I love you.
Reggie and Justin.
Yay.
Thanks so much, guys, for coming down to Altspace VR.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. Oh, shit.
Something like, I think it's like 60-plus sensors from head to toe that they were wearing.
Well,
yeah, so
how?
No, I don't know. I don't know. It's possible, but I don't know what their schedule is. Some they have before jumped in, but I don't know what kind of schedule they've got.